Okay, so topic for today's presentation is threaded binary tree, pre-order traversal, and how we can create the threaded binary tree. So last time we have seen that threaded binary tree is nothing but the binary tree in which we are utilizing the null links. So left null link will be pointing to the in-order predecessor, and right null link will be pointing to the in-order successor. So this is the representation of threaded binary tree, where null link of the leaf node is pointing to the in-order predecessor and right link is pointing to the in-order successor. So these links, whatever may be null links utilized, these links are shown with the dotted lines. Here these lines are not clear, but these links are shown with the dotted lines, while actual links are shown or represented with the solid lines. So that is the differentiation, how we can differentiate between the actual link and thread. So actual link will be represented by solid line, while thread or the null link that is utilized will be represented by dotted lines. So we'll go to the pre-order traversal. So this is pre-order traversal algorithm. So this is very much similar to the pre-order traversal of binary tree using non-recursive algorithm. So what we are doing in that, so we are starting with this one head node, and then we are traversing to the leftmost child. So whenever we are traversing, we are printing the nodes on the go, and once we are at the leaf node, then from the leaf node we are popping the element from the stack to come back to the parent node, and then we are moving towards the right side, and then the same algorithm will be continued. So same thing is done here. If you see here, so starting with this one, current equal to left pointer of head. Why we have taken this one? Because in our representation here we will be having the root node, and root of left will be this one, our actual tree. So it is taken as current equal to left of head. So we can start from this node. So we are checking whether this is null. If it is null, that means we are not going to perform the traversal. So this condition is checked here. If current equal to head, that means left of this is pointing to only head itself. So we are having the empty tree. So no need to traverse. So if it is empty, skip and return back. If it is not empty, then what we are doing? We are traversing to the leftmost node here. And while traversal, we are printing the nodes, as this is the pre-order traversal. So here simply we are traversing to the leftmost node, and while traversal we are writing the data. So this is done here. So write the data, okay, and move towards the left side. So this is the loop we can consider here, okay. And what we are doing? Write data, suppose write 6, and then left thread of current is not equal to 0, whether this is the leaf node. So if left thread equal to 0, that means it is not the leaf node. Okay, so if it is 0, go towards this node. So for this it is 0. So we are printing this one, and we are simply moving current equal to left pointer of current. So we are coming at this node. Then else part I will explain that later. We are again coming back to this one. Current is not head. So write this data and move the pointer to the left side, this one. We are at this stage. Okay. Then again, write the data. Then left thread of current is equal to 0. Now it is not 0, it is 1. So we are breaking this one loop. So once we are at this stage, what we are doing? We are following the link to this one, so that we can come back to the parent node. And once we are at the parent node, what we are doing? We are moving towards the right side, and from the right side again same procedure. Is that clear? Any questions so far? So in the pre-order traversal, what we have done, we are starting with this node, okay, and while we are not at the leaf node, we are traversing this one. Okay, and while traversing, we are printing that one. And once we are at this last node, if it is last one, then simply follow the chain. So if this is not zero, that means if this is one, if we are at the leaf node, that is the left thread is current equal to this one. So if left thread is one, that means we are at the leaf node. If we are at the leaf node, simply we are following this right link, that is the right thread. So this one, current equal to right of current. Okay, and then again go back this one. So once we are at this, one more statement is here. You can see current equal to current pointing right, and from this we can continue the algorithm. Now what is this condition? Repeat. Why we are repeating? Because in some cases, like at this stage, suppose we are at this node, okay, and once we print this, we are coming back to the this one parent node, but at the parent E1, we are not having the right child, we are not having the right link. If we are not having the right link, that means we are simply following the thread. So this is while loop. While right thread is equal to one, follow the link. So we can come at this stage, and then current equal to right pointer of current, we can come at this stage, and then same algorithm is followed. So any question from student side? Pre-order traversal. Yes. If it is not, we can move towards the next part. Yes, any question from student side? Okay, so we can move towards the next part, that is the creation of threaded binary tree. So creation of threaded binary tree is very much similar to creation of binary tree. Here extra thing is that we need to manage the null link properly. That's the thing only that is to be considered while creating the threaded binary tree. Algorithm is similar to the binary tree creation only. So whatever may be non-recursive algorithm we have used for creation of binary tree, same algorithm is followed there. Just we are updating some code in order to manage the null links that we are utilizing and assigning at a proper place. So we are going to see it in detail. What is that algorithm? So this is just to create the root node. So whatever may be code shown here, so this is just creating the root node. We have seen that in the threaded binary tree, we are having the root node. So it is just creating the root node. So if root equal to null, so what we are doing, we are allocating the memory in this statement and assign left thread equal to right thread equal to one. That is means this is the only node. If it is left thread is one, that means that is representing the null link. We have seen this representation in the last lecture. So left thread equal to right thread is equal to one. So assign the memory in this statement and then assign thread equal to one. Now left pointer, right pointer is equal to head because we are just having the root. So in this case, left pointer will assign to the root itself and right pointer is getting assigned to the root itself because we are not having the here actual tree. If we are having the actual tree, this left pointer will get assigned to the root node here. So same thing, left pointer of head equal to the temporary and root equal to the temporary. So just we are creating the root node of threaded binary tree, nothing else. So once root node is created, then what we are doing? So we are inserting the node. So here insertion code is given here. Very much similar to the binary tree insertion. So what we are doing, if left pointer of head equal to head, that means root is null. So if root is null, we are simply creating the root, that is left pointer of head equal to create the root. So that means if we are having the empty tree, first create the root at this position. So once root is created, then here we are going at this stage. That means once root is created, we are having some tree here. So we are assigning parent equal to left pointer of head. So there may be tree there. So if we are having the root node, So left side will be null and parent will get assigned null. If it is having some node, that node will get assigned to the parent. So we are just moving parent pointer at the first node of tree in this statement. And this flag is managed to continue the process. Still hot thing, we are continuing. So this is just for managing the loop, nothing else. So that is used here, while flag is true, continue the process. Okay, so here what we are doing, suppose some nodes we are having in the tree. So what we are doing in the binary tree, same way we are doing here. So write root is, here we are printing the data of this node, and then we are asking user whether you want to insert to the left side of this node or right side of this node. So we are printing the content of node here, and then we are asking user for his or her choice that whether to insert to the left of this node or right of this node, and then we are getting that choice. So this is, so that is simple one. Create the root. If root is already created, assign the starting of the tree to the parent and then continue. So print the parent data and ask for the user choice whether user want to insert to the left side or right side. So here is the next part. Once we get the choice, okay, then if choice is one, that means user want to insert to the left side. If choice is two, here it should be two, okay, so case two, okay. So if it is two, then we are inserting to the right side. So code is simply, if user want to insert, suppose we are at this stage, so we are traversing, so else part you can see here. So what is the condition in the case one? If user want to insert to the left side, then we are checking left thread of the parent is equal to one. So we are checking whether this is the last node, because we are inserting at the last level at the leaves. So we are checking whether this is the leaf node. If it is not the leaf node, then simply parent equal to left pointer of parent, because user want to enter to the left side. So we are coming here. Again, next time we'll get the choice from the user, that is code that we have seen. So get the choice, again we are coming here. So suppose we are at this position now, we are assuming that we are at this position. So we are at this position. So we are checking left thread of parent is equal to one. Yes, left thread is one, because this is the null link, utilized link. So we are at this position. Then what we are doing? Get the node. So we are creating the new node here, and then we are assigning left pointer of new, that is the new node. This is, so left pointer of new equal to left pointer of parent. So simply we are assigning this left pointer at this node, to this node, and we are again assigning right pointer to the parent at this position. So why this is? Because left pointer is pointing to the in order predecessor. So you can see here, while traversing, one will be traversed, three will be traversed. So one will be printed, three will be printed, then we are coming to the right and then leftmost. So this will get printed after three. So we are assigning this left pointer to the in order predecessor here. So simply how we are assigning? Left pointer of new equal to left pointer of parent, and right pointer should get assigned to the parent itself, because this parent will be visited after this node in the in order traversal. So we are just assigning the links. So left link and right link. And then what we are doing? Left thread of new node equal to right thread of new node equal to one, because as this is the leaf node, we are assigning thread equal to one, because this is representing the thread. So this will be one. And then left pointer of parent equal to new, we are assigning this pointer. So we are connecting this new node to the existing tree. And then left thread of parent equal to zero. Initially this was the thread, okay? So we have removed this and we have assigned this here. So initially it was one, as this was the thread. Now we are making it zero, because this is not the leaf node. So just we are making it zero. So that's all. Simply we are adding new node, assigning the link to the proper nodes, connecting that node and assigning the threads. That's all. And as we have inserted flag equal to false, we are making it false so that we can stop the loop. So same way here, case two, if it is the case two, same thing we are doing. So we are creating the new node, okay? So case two, suppose for this, we are inserting in this here right side of 5. So what we are doing, right pointer, assign this right pointer of parent. So we'll assign this here, and then left pointer equal to parent itself. So this one, and then similar way, assign this to one as this is the leaf node, and right pointer of parent equal to new. So right pointer will get assigned to here, and then make this 0. So in this way, we are inserting into the right side of the given node. Okay, so any question from your side? Yes, any question? So that is how we are inserting into the threaded binary tree. So the algorithm we have seen, simple steps. So we are starting with the root node, and then we are moving towards the leaf node. At this node, we are asking whether to insert to the left side or right side. Suppose we are inserting to the left side of 6. So at this stage, user will enter the 1. At this stage, user will enter 2. At this stage, 1. And once we are at this position, we can follow this code. And we can insert the node into the tree. So any question from student side? So we have seen how we are traversing by using the pre-order traversal and how we are inserting into the threaded binary tree. So these are some of the applications of tree: expression tree, set representation, decision tree, and game tree. So these are the applications of tree. So to summarize, we have seen that threaded binary tree is binary tree where we are utilizing the null links. Left null link will be pointing to the in-order predecessor of the current node, while right null link will be pointing to the in-order successor of the current node that is considered. And why we are using this threaded binary tree? So threaded binary tree is basically we are using for the traversal purpose. We need not to use the extra data structure in order to traverse the tree. So without using any extra data structure, we can traverse the tree, whether it is the in-order, pre-order, or post-order, very easily.